His charm is so contagious, even John Tortorella smiles around him. His name does not appear on the Stanley Cup, but the Hall of Fame has offered to add it anyway. He offers to babysit the kids of people he's never met. He is Tyson Nash, the most intriguing man in hockey.
Tyson, time for Tyson Nash. There he is.
Look at him. All clean, you know, shaven, looking good.
I got to say, Tyson Nash probably knows Howler pretty good.
Listen, I've never seen both of them in the same place.
I don't know what that means, but there's a rumor that Tyson is Howler.
Yeah.
Can you confirm that's not true, Tyson?
Well, I can tell you we have the same nose. So.
You're not going to say anymore.
Yeah.
All right, well, let's talk about the Coyotes.
Let's do this.
The Coyotes are in the mix.
Everyone's in the mix in the West.
But that includes the Coyotes.
That's right.
They have fought their way back into this playoff race. Tyson, what's the buzz around the room right now? The guys feeling good or what?
You know what? Everyone's feeling really good. They put two huge wins together. This is a team that obviously has been decimated by injuries. I still think one of the best stories in the entire National Hockey League. What Rick Tocchet has been able to do with this group, continuing to find ways to win hockey games. The goaltending has been outstanding. The scoring, the secondary scoring, the power play, Galchenyuk. I mean, everyone's firing on all cylinders right now, and they're feeling really good about themselves.
We like, first of all, you see the standings right here. So absolutely, the Coyotes are right in the mix. We like that you've got the FaceTime, the phone right up against the, it looks like the Gatorade jug there. It is. Yes, very nice. You're a creative. You are a creative individual, so we appreciate that.
That's my best side right there. That's my best side.
No, come on. You're very, very handsome fella. Let's talk about the Blues, because you got Darren Pang and the Blues tonight coming to town. He's a troublemaker. We know that. But what are you expecting from this game tonight against St. Louis? They've been red hot.
Well, I know I could probably take Panger. He's going to be in the in between the benches with me tonight, so I might stick him in my pocket tonight. this is obviously the Coyotes as well as they're playing. They're playing one of the hottest teams in the National Hockey League in the St. Louis Blues. Team the Coyotes have had some early success this year against, but as we all know, this is a much different St. Louis Blues team. The goaltending. Goaltending's always been an issue in St. Louis ever since I played there. And not anymore. Bennington has really solved those problems for them, giving them a chance to win every night. And you know, the goals they're scoring right now. They're just outscoring, plain and simple, the opposition. So the Coyotes are going to be in one here tonight. Defensively, Darcy Kemper is going to have to stand on his melon.
Tyce, I agree with you. The Coyotes have been a great story, obviously. They've had so many injuries. It hasn't got nearly as much play as it should. And yet they have found ways to hang around this race. What's different for you, though? How have they been doing it? What really stands out?
Well, it's been everybody. They got six guys now with 11 goals. Galchenyuk finally hit that 12 mark. I mean, that's not impressive, but as a whole, you know, that's saying something. Defensively, how they're playing. Everybody's playing a bigger role, and it's kind of galvanized this group, believe it or not, with all the injuries, because these are some guys that are like, hey, I'm never going to play this much normally, so this is my time to really get it done. Connor Garland has come up and put up huge numbers. I don't even think he ever would have been called up if not for the injury. So you see him with 11 goals. Galchenyuk is finally starting to play like the guy that John Chyka hoped he would be when they made that big trade with Max Domi. He's got 4 goals in his last 5 games. Big part of the power play. Special teams is everything in the National Hockey League. And right now the Coyotes power play is red hot.
Well, you just listed off a few players that are producing a lot as of late. The Oats have been getting contributions from up and down the lineup. Who's behind the balanced attack here?
Well, as I mentioned, I mean, goaltending is everything. So besides the attack, you know, the other night, Darcy Kemper was absolutely ridiculous. They were, I think they had 41 shots in that game, the Knights did. You know how they come out in that building. And he weathered a storm. There were 16 shots in that first period, 9 scoring chances. That was the big number for me. If he doesn't make those big saves, all of a sudden you're chasing the game. You're down 2-0. And again, his numbers as a whole aren't that outstanding, but 74 saves on 79 shots. They're getting it done, and they're getting the offense in front of them as well.
All right, well, Arizona Coyotes back in action tonight. Should be a good game. Tyson, happy Valentine's Day.
Yes.
I hope you took your wife out on an off day recently before today, because obviously you're working tonight.
I took her to the all-you-can-eat buffet this afternoon. So.
Ah, well played.
I'm a giver. ever. I had a group on.
Smart man. All right, enjoy the game tonight, Tyson. Always a pleasure.
See you guys.